In this video, we will take a look at the characteristics and presentation of migraines.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Headaches can manifest on their own, but are also a very common symptom in neck pain patients, as more than 60% of patients with a primary neck pain complaint report of having concordant episodes of headache. Therefore, it's essential to find out what kind of headache the patient is suffering from. To start off, let's differentiate between primary and secondary types of headaches. But what does that mean? Simply put, primary headaches are a disease themselves, whereas in secondary headaches, the headache is a symptom of another condition. So, primary headaches would be migraines, tension-type headaches, and cluster headaches. Secondary-type headaches are headaches caused by tumors, hemorrhage, other trauma, TMJ dysfunction, substance overdose, or neck pain, aka the cervicogenic headache. Now, let's take a closer look at migraines, which are a primary type headache. Migraines have a mean one-year prevalence of 11.2% around the world, with women being more often affected than men in an age range between 20 to 50 years. Migraines exist in two distinct forms, that is either with or without the presence of a phenomenon called aura, but we will get to that later. In order for a headache to qualify as migraines, it has to fulfill certain criteria. A. There have to have been a minimum of 5 attacks fulfilling the following criteria. B. The headache lasts from 4 to 72 hours. The duration is an essential characteristic because if an untreated episode lasts less than 4 or more than 72 hours, migraines are excluded. C. The headache has at least 2 of the 4 following characteristics, which are 1. It's a unilateral headache. 2. The headache has a pulsating quality. 3. It has a moderate to severe pain intensity. Or 4. The headache is aggravated by routine physical activity, such as climbing stairs. And D. Next to the headache, patients have at least one of the following additional symptoms. These are nausea or vomiting, and being sensitive to bright lights and sounds called photo and phonophobia, respectively. In order for a headache to be classified as migraine with aura, a patient has to present with the previously mentioned criteria and one or more reversible aura symptom. These are disturbances in the following subsystems: visual, sensory, speech, motor, brainstem, or retina. Imagine vision changes, numbness, dizziness, confusion, etc. Furthermore, at least 2 of the 4 characteristics have to apply. 1. At least one aura symptom spreads gradually over more than 5 minutes, and or 2 or more symptoms occur in succession. 2. Each individual aura symptom lasts 5 to 60 minutes. 3. At least one aura symptom is unilateral. And 4. The aura is accompanied or followed within 60 minutes by headache. While aura symptoms resemble those of a CVA, they build up much slower, over 5 minutes compared to within seconds in a CVA. Tools you can use to assess the impact of a headache on your patient are the HIT-6 questionnaire, which you can find in the video description down below. Also note that it can be difficult for a patient to answer all the questions on duration, intensity, and characteristics of their headache during your assessment. Therefore, asking them to complete something like a headache diary can help in the assessment and management of the headache, and you should be aware that there can be an overlap between multiple headache disorders. Okay, in the intro I mentioned that headaches are quite often associated with neck pain, so be sure to click on our neck pain guideline playlist on the left. Please check the links in the video description down below to learn more about ways to support us, such as our ebook, app, or online course. And as always, this was Andreas from Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.